Hey guys, Vikas over here and you are watching We Are Genius. Guys, today I am again with a new video around Raspberry Pi. We will see how to use watchdog timer of Raspberry Pi by using Java. And for this we are going to use Pi4j Java library for Raspberry Pi. Coming on to watchdog timer, it is a hardware timer that automatically generates a system reset if the main program neglects to periodically service it or basically if the program is stuck in some execution. Many microcontrollers, including the Raspberry Pi, comes with watchdog timer. How the watchdog timer works is, you need to first load the timer with a certain amount of time that is a bit higher compared to the worst case execution time of your program. And we need to reset the timer before the time reaches the set timer time. Now the timer has to be reset periodically in the program within the set time. Otherwise the timer will create a system reset and will reboot the controller. So think of a situation, your application has got stuck somewhere due to hardware or software failures and it won't be able to reset the watchdog timer, and due to that the timer will generate a system reset and will reboot the controller. So this comes handy with microcontrollers as they might get into some hang or the freeze situation and they won't be able to reset themselves. We need to physically reboot them. And for that we need to get into the controller and press the button or something, and we need to manually do that. But if you are using the watchdog timer, it can be done automatically. And as if the controller gets freezed or got stuck somewhere during the execution due to some hardware or software failures, the watchdog timer will itself reboot the controller, making the controller start from again the beginning. So this kind of helps to run the microcontroller smoothly. So being said that, let's get started guys. So guys, as I said earlier, we'll be working with Pi4j library. So let's first download the latest release from pi4j.org. And for this, I have actually given the link down below in the description. So over here, get into direct download and get the latest snapshot build. The download is about 7 MB. So just wait for it till it gets downloaded. Now, after the download completes, get into a folder wherever you have downloaded and extract the zip file. Get into the extracted files and over here you'll find three folders, that is bin, examples and leaf. And the library that we'll be using is the 54j4.char file, which is inside the leaf folder. So just make it for that. And over here in examples folder, you will get whole lot of examples for different platforms. So just minimize this and let's open up Eclipse, which we'll be using to create our watchdog timer project. So you can use any IDE that you are familiar with, but I'll be using Eclipse over here. Again, if you are new to Java application development on Raspberry Pi or any other platform, make sure to check my earlier videos on Nano Pi, Orange Pi and Raspberry Pi. So over here let's create a simple project, that is WDT example, and I'll just make everything else as default. Create a new class, main class, click on finish. Now we need to add the required library to our project. And as in Eclipse, you can get into build path, click on add external jar file, get into the folder where you have extracted the files that you have downloaded from pi4j.org, get into leaf folder, add the pi4j.go.jar file and hit on OK. We don't need anything else. Now I'll just copy this watchdog timer code over here. Copy this code, paste it over here. Okay. Again, this code is actually available in the example section or the example folder, but I have modified a bit, and for that I have given the link to my GitHub repository. So I'll just rename the type to main class. So let's get through the code and see what is happening. So over here, first we have created one object of the WT timer class, that is the watchdog timer. Then we need to open it up, so it will initiate. and after that one function is used, that is watchdog dot get timeout. So this gives you the current set timeout for the watchdog timer. And if you are not setting up the like timeout in your project, it will take the last set timeout. So if you have set any timeout earlier, it will take that one. Now again, this uses the on chip watchdog timer, as I said earlier. So it will give you the last timeout that we have set or something. Then this is printing out the timeout. Then you can set your timeout, that is again between 1 to 15 second, by using the function that is set timeout, and it has to be between 1 to 15 seconds, otherwise it will throw errors. After that, the main or important function is the heartbeat function, which has to be called within the set timeout. So if you are let's say setting it for 15 seconds, you need to call it the heartbeat function within 15 seconds or every 15 seconds, otherwise it will make the Raspberry Pi reboot. After that, if you want to like disable the watchdog timer, you need to call watchdog.disable and watchdog.close. Again, let's say you are closing your application and your application no more runs, you should call this function, otherwise what will happen is, as you have set the timeout and as our application has already exited, it will not be calling the heartbeat function, and this will again make the Pi reboot. So make sure whenever your application exits, you need to call disable and close functions. Now let's check it out if it works. So over here, what I'll do is I'll make the thread sleep. Let's say first we'll make it for some small time, that is lesser than this 15 second, let's say 10 second, and let's see if the Raspberry Pi reboots, and then we'll make the time higher than this, and let's see if the Pi will reboot or not. So to do that, I'll need to transfer the executable jar file, and to run this application on Raspberry Pi, I just need to create the executable jar file again that I have shown in my earlier videos, and link for those are in the description down below. So I have connected my Raspberry Pi to the network, so I'll be using WinSCP to transfer the executable jar files. Click on login. Let's open up Putty so that we can run the program on the remote terminal. Now let's transfer the recently generated executable jar files as well as the required libraries. Now to run the file, I just need to execute it, and by using sudo java jar path to the file, that is index of, then the file name jar. Now you can see as the time is less than 15 second, that is for around 10 second, it has successfully executed up to this statement, that is it has printed watchdog closed. Now let's modify this and make it, let's say 18 second, and as the thread is getting into sleep state for 18 second, that is higher than this 15 second, it should reboot the Pi. Oh sorry, I just forgot to add, this is actually in millisecond, just to like that only. Let's upload it once more. Let's see if it is executing. So as for so it should reboot and shouldn't print this watchdog.close statement. The Putty should close in a while. So just let's wait for around 15 seconds to make it happen. Let's check if it has rebooted. Yep, you can see over here the Putty has closed because the Pi has rebooted, and this has worked. So let's see if it has successfully rebooted. Yep, it has again started. So guys, this is a basic example like how to use the watchdog timer using Java. Again, over here this is a simple example, so it depends upon your application. You need to modify this. Again, don't forget to call the disable and close function whenever your application exits from running state. So again, this is a simple example. One more thing, the watchdog timer don't take care of other applications, those are running in background. So if you are running multiple applications, make sure you save the required data and all if it is required, and sync between applications accordingly. So guys, I hope you have liked this video. If so, hit the thumbs up button, and if you have not subscribed yet, get subscribed to get notified whenever I upload videos like this. So see you next time with my next video. Till then, goodbye.